Well, this attack has sparked outcry from other families who feel that bullying has not been properly addressed within the school district. And so on Wednesday, those families plan to hold a protest here at the high school demanding change. We should warn you, some of these details are graphic.
I've told them things I've never told anybody else before, and they use that against me. They mentally screwed with me.
15-year-old Sean thought a group of classmates at Wellesley High were his friends, but he says things escalated from taunting to bullying and finally physical violence.
Kill yourself, no one likes you. He embarrassed me as much as he could. He made sure that I didn't feel good about myself.
Then over the summer in July, Sean was lured to his old elementary school and attacked.
My head was slammed into the pavement. I was kicked, punched, elbowed, spit on, pissed on. I was terrified.
The attack sent Sean to the emergency room. No lasting injuries, but the emotional scars linger.
I think about it every day.
A police report says some of the teens were charged with conspiracy and assault and battery and sent to juvenile court. But now some of the boys will return to school after serving suspensions. Sean's family says it's too soon.
One child was only kept out for 10 and a half days, the other not even 30. I would have liked them to have consequences that were more fitting to the crimes.
The family says the school failed to follow its own 12-page bullying policy, offering little support to their son.
The support for our son has been meager to nothing. The plan and policy is beautifully written, but they are not following through with any of this.
I have to see two of them at school, the ones coming back tomorrow that I'm most worried about, because him and his friends, I've heard what they've said in the past, and it is not in any way right. It's mentally disturbing.
And tonight, Wellesley Public Schools says that they are taking this bullying incident very seriously, going on to say, quote, "When we were informed of this situation, we promptly investigated and disciplined the students involved according to state regulations, and safety planning was immediately enacted and remains in place to help ensure that all students feel secure and supported." We're live in Wellesley. Sean Chiabot, WCVB News Center 5.
Sean, thank you very much.